Kim, and I'm gonna be doing a 2014 favorites video for you. It's a compilation of every single thing I've loved in 2014, and it includes beauty, fashion, iPhone apps, movies, and music. Yeah, basically everything I've loved in 2014. And I hope you like it. I'm just gonna start. So let's go into fashion first. My first favorite is this black parka. It's from Oops Kooky and it's really, really cute. It's just a simple layering piece for Singapore's weather, considering that it's super hot and you can't wear that more than like one layer. And I just feel that this is like the perfect jacket for me. It fits me really well, so I really, really like it, and it has gold detailing. And the best part is that it has pockets. I'm a sucker for pockets because I can like just throw everything in. And I always wear this to school because classes are really cold, so this can also protect me from the cold. My next favorite are these shorts. These are shorts from Factorie. I think they call it running shorts, I'm not really sure, but yeah, it's super comfy and I always wear it on like lazy days. Like you can wear it to sleep. Yeah, and the print's really, really nice too. I'm not sure if you can. I'm gonna focus it for you. But yeah, this is the print. It's just like a tropical black and white print. And yeah, it has its drawstring. And I've been wearing it to death on lazy days or on any day. Because, I mean, you can dress it up, you can dress it down. So, these shorts are really, really an essential for me in my 2014 year. And then my last clothing favorite are these Young Hungry Free ripped jeans. They're just like ripped, like they're not fully ripped like the whole thing, but it's just at the knee and it's a bit high-waisted. And I don't know, I just recently got into jeans and these are my favorite pair. Moving on to accessories, I have this bag. It's also from Young Hungry Free. It's just a simple slouchy bag that only has like a handle at the back, so like, you know, this part will like slouch down. And it has gold detailing. It also has a strap so that you can put it over your shoulder like this. And it's just really, really convenient because you can wear it in three different ways. I use it to store my laptop, and sometimes my bag gets too heavy. So when it gets too heavy, I have to, like, it's all leaning on one shoulder and it really, really hurts. So the thing about this bag is that you can actually change it to a backpack at the back. I'm just gonna show it to you. They just give you an extra strap inside the bag, so I just normally put it inside my bag. Here's the other one, and then I just clip it onto the bag, so it becomes a backpack, as you can see. Or you could hold it like this, like if you like it this way, just be like this. These are Topshop Slip Ons. I've been wearing them a lot lately, like this whole year actually, since I bought them. I got them on sales for about 30 bucks. Yeah, and it's really, really easy to match because it's black and white, like everything in my closet. It's what do you call this? I forgot what it's called, like pony hair. Is it pony hair? I'm just gonna like try and read it. It's not like, what is this called? Yeah, but it's this like fur material, like wool material. And then I have jewelry. It's this Rue Jambon circle necklace. It's just a simple necklace. It's really delicate and it's just a circle. But I really like how it looks, so I just like putting it on when sometimes, like, you know, my outfit is too dressed up, and a chunky like statement necklace wouldn't go really well with it because it would be like too, like, you know, like loud or something. So I just match it with this necklace. Okay, so now I'm gonna talk to you about my beauty favorites. My first beauty favorite is this eyeliner pen from Maybelline. It is a hyper sharp liner. And this is the one in Dalmatian print, but this is my third dupe. So I think this is like the limited edition one or something, but I'm not sure. But yeah, I bought this in Japan, so maybe the Japan one is like Dalmatian print. This glides on really, really smoothly, and it's super thin, so instead of all those like thick eyeliners, you can really, really like line it where you want it to, and as thin as you want it to be. If you want thin eyeliner, this is the eyeliner you should go for. It's the best. My next favorite is this Rocket mascara, and it's also from Maybelline. It's called the Rocket Volume Express. It just gives my lashes so much volume. I used to use the Magnum mascara from Maybelline, but I don't know, that just made my lashes really, really long, and I wanted it to have volume along with like the length, so it wasn't really working out well for me. And then I decided to try this Rocket mascara. I have this Hoola bronzer to contour my face. I've used quite a bit of it, but yeah, I know a lot of people use this bronzer, and I have to say it's it really contours my face shape really well. Like, I just do like use another brush, like a blush brush or a contour brush, but yeah, I just do the three, like the CE, is it? I'm not sure. Do you call it DE? But yeah, I just like that, and then like that. I got into eyeshadow this year, but I'm no expert at it. I'm still like, I still don't know how like blend, like mix and stuff. But yeah, what I've been doing is using this NYX. I'm so sorry, it's so dirty, but this NYX eye pencil. It is 617 and iced mocha, and it's just this gold, bronzy, shimmery color. I'm wearing it on my eye now. Just this like subtle brown color on my eyes. And then after applying this, it's really easy to apply through. You just like color it on your eyelids, because it's like a pencil and it's like cream eyeshadow. Yeah, but yeah. And then after that, I put this eyeshadow from Innisfree. It is the Mineral Single Shadow 27, and it's a darker brown with shimmer inside, and it's bronze. It's also this like bronze color, but it is dark, much darker than the NYX one. Then I just like dust it with like my eyeshadow brush, and then I just put it to like near the like side of my eye, and then I'll just like kind of like mix it in. This is the Marc Jacobs Daisy Dream perfume, and it has been my favorite this year. Yeah, it's just this really, I don't know how to describe perfume scents. Okay, it's really floral, it's really sweet, it's kind of like the child of like Marc Jacobs Daisy, but this is like the Daisy Dream one. But yeah, it smells really great, really good. And I got it in this small bottle. My boyfriend bought it for me, and I've been in love with it since. Marc Jacobs Daisy is sweeter, and Daisy Dream is not as sweet as Daisy. So yeah, I like both of them a lot though. That's all my fashion and beauty favorites. I'm just gonna move on to all the other favorites I've been into. I'm just gonna start with my iPhone apps. So one of the apps I've been really into this year is Wunderlist. It's kind of just like a checklist thing where you can key in all the things that you need to do, and then you can sync it to your computer, because they have an app on the computer as well, and you can create lists, and then in the list you can create what you need to do. So it's really organized, and you can set alarms. So I just use it to keep track of all my work and all the things I have to do. My next favorite app is this McDonald's app, the Secret Alarm app. It's a really, really cute app, and then you can, you know, time your alarm and stuff. I'm really hard to wake up, so I really, really need like a really loud alarm to wake up. And the iPhone one doesn't really work for me anymore. And one more favorite game I've been playing. I haven't played this for a year. I only actually started playing it yesterday, so it's not really counted as like a yearly favorite. But it is the Sim City building. It's super fun. Like, I really, really love it. Because I used to play Sims a lot when I was young. Like, whether it was on like the PSP or like the Game Boy or the computer, like, I played every single like Sims game from Sims Double Deluxe. I started from Sims Double Deluxe, and then I went on to Sims 2 and then Sims 3. But I haven't played Sims 4, but I also played the PSP and the Game Boy one and the phone one, and now I'm playing Sim City. I used to play Sim City on the computer, but I never really got a hang of it. But since the app stores had this Sim City app, I decided to like download it because my boyfriend was playing it, and it's really fun. Like, I'm obsessed with it, that I can't stop playing it. Another favorite of mine is this planner thing from Muji. My friend Ains gave it to me for my birthday last year, and it was for 2014. And it's just such a compact organizer. Like, I love organizers. I like writing my stuff, like what I need to do inside. Like all the due dates and stuff, you can like keep it like really... I just feel that like keeping it in your iPhone calendar, you can't really see it as a whole. Like, instead of like just writing inside here and then flipping the page to see what you have due next week. Yeah, and I don't know, I like just writing inside and stuff. So yeah, I filled up the whole organizer since January. It's from Muji and it fits into my bag. It's really small. I can put it into my super small bag, like big bag, small bags. I just put it inside and I can just record everything inside here. Moving on, I have my favorite movies. My favorite movies are, let's see, I have two this year, the ones that just came out. It is The Fury. It stars Brad Pitt and it's him during World War II fighting Germans. So that was really interesting. Like, it was, I don't know, it was just a lot of teamwork and bonding and relationships and it during the wartime and when they fought. So it was really nice, it was really intense. I really, really loved it. And the next one is Dracula Untold. It stars Luke Evans and he is the guy who acted as Bart in The Hobbit, if you watched it. But yeah, so this is a story about how this guy tries to save his land and he turns into a Dracula. And I mean, it's like, it's not really like the typical like vampire story, but it's really, really heartwarming. The last part has like a plot twist, so that was really interesting too. If you want to watch like an action movie, you should really, really catch Dracula Untold. This is the end of my 2014 favorites video. If you have any comments or questions, you can leave it in the comment section down below. You can also tell me what is your favorite item for 2014. And it'll be really interesting to hear because, yeah, favorites videos are one of like my favorite things to watch. So this is why I decided to do one for you guys. And if you're watching, hi! I hope 2015 goes really well for you and everything that you want to do. And I'll see you in my next video. Bye! Come.